Hi friends, my name is Kapil Gayal and in this tutorial I will teach you about the WP query. What we can do with WP query? We can fetch the post and pages by the WP query. It is a WordPress default function by which we can get our post and pages in our template. Now I have already created a template with the name query test. Here I have already get our footer and header in the template. Now I have already set it on the query test page. This is our page for this template. This is our header and this is our footer. You can see there is no data in between the header and footer because we have not fetched any data yet in our template. Now friends, I will show you how can you get the title of your post in the template with the WP query. Now first I am going to the documentation of WP query. Here you can see the first link, WP underscore query class developer.wordpress.org. open this link. Now friends, so here you can see all the documentation of the WP query. This is the documentation of the WP query. Here you can see the standard loop of the WP query. Now friends, what we have to do, we will write our own code. So how can we write our code? Here we will write PHP tag, close this PHP tag. Here we will start our coding. Now here first we will create a array with the arguments. This is our variable where we will store our array. Array, we will create a associative array here. This is our array. Now first type inverted single inverted commas and in between this type post type, post underscore type. We have to define the post type here. First we will fetch the data of our post. So what we have to do here, type post. And now what we have to do, we will give this variable in between the WP query object. Copy this from here and paste it here. Now here you can see a variable, the underscore query is equal to new WP query, and in between this there is a parameter named args, which is our array. This one is our array. Here you can see this is our array. We will pass our array here, and this is the WordPress default class. I want to show you, first go to your WP includes folder and here search for class WP query. This is our file. Here you can see class WP query. This is our class. And this is our object. Now, what we have to do, we will write our loop here. If the underscore query have posts, then if this variable has post, now this code will run. Now while whenever there are posts, then this loop will run. This is a loop of our post. Now here you can also copy the code from here. You can change the variable name to anything which you want, XYZ, and change this here also. Now friends, what we have to do here, we have already closed the loop here. Now I want to fetch the title of our post. So what we have to do, echo the underscore title. This one is our function for fetch the title. If I save this and run our front end, here you can see a title here, because there is only one post in the default post. Here you can see one post only. These posts are in default currently. That's why it is not showing in the front end. Now, what we will do, we will fetch our product in the front end, not the default post. So, what we have to do, we have to change our post type in the template. Copy this post type from here, paste it here, save this, and if I run our template front end, now here you can see the titles, but it is not currently in the formatted form. BR. Here you can see the titles 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Here you can see 10 posts in the front end, because if I go to reading, here you can see the blog pages show at most 10 posts. Now if we will increase our limit from here, then let's see what happened. Now you can see all the posts here, but this is not the correct way to show all the posts in the front end. So we will change this back to the 10 post. Now if I refresh this, here you can see the 10 posts. What we have to do, we will write a parameter in our array, comma, and here type a parameter posts per page. this is the parameter here. If I write to post, then let's see what happen. It will show only to post on the front end. This is a associative array, that's why it is showing error. Here you can see only to post, but I want to fetch all the post in our template. So what we have to do, we will write -1 here. If I refresh this page, it will show all the titles of our products. Now here we have fetched our title. Change this to query, copy paste, copy paste, save. It is working fine. Now copy this function from here, delete this, close this PHP tag here and open this here. Now what we will do, we will write this title in the h2 tag. This is the h2 tag here. Open PHP tag and in between this type echo the underscore title. Now what we have, if I run this, now I want to fetch the content of our post in this loop. What we will do, open PHP tag, close PHP tag here and type here the underscore content. It will show the content. I am talking about this one. This is our content. Now if I save this and run this, you can see the content of our post here. But I want to show the excerpt from here. We will change this to excerpt. If I save this and reload our front end, you can see the excerpt here. This is our excerpt called short description also. Now friends, in the next tutorial we will fetch the categories in the front end portion, this category in the front end. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.